This is a picture test in practical histology of the cardiovascular system. You may use the video as a revision for the topic or as a self-assessment tool. For the purpose of self-assessment, pause the video at the beginning of each slide and take your time in reading the question and coming up with the answer. Then replay the video to confirm your answer and listen to further comments and explanations. Identify the type of blood vessel, be specific. List two named vessels in the body whose wall has a similar features. What is the functional role of the tunica indicated by the star? This slide shows the basic three components of the wall of a blood vessel. Tunica intima, although the endothelial lining and subendothelial connective tissue is not clear in this magnification, but the internal elastic lamina is a prominent, densely staving wavy line at the junction with the tunica media. Then the tunica media, which is made up of smooth muscle cells, concentrically arranged, as you can see here in this section. Elastic fibers, some of them are sparsely seen, and most of the connective tissue fibers in the tunica media are collagen fibers. The outer layer is the tunica adventitia, which shows collagenous connective tissue, and as you can see here that it is separated from the tunica media by an external elastic lamina, another dark stained wavy line. These are the typical features of a muscular artery, in which you can find thick, predominantly muscular tunica media and the presence of elastic laminae at its borders. However, an external elastic lamina could be absent in small muscular arteries. As for the second part of the question, most of the named arteries in the body are muscular arteries, such as brachial artery, radial, ulnar, femoral, popliteal, tibial, to name but a few. For the third part of the question, the functional role of the tunica indicated by the asterisk, which is the tunica media, as we have just mentioned that there are large amounts of smooth muscles in the tunica media, and these smooth muscles help control the size of the lumen and hence regulate the distribution of blood flow to various organs. That's why these arteries, these muscular arteries, are also called distributing arteries. It should be mentioned that the internal elastic lamina belongs to tunica intima and external elastic lamina belongs to tunica adventitia, but some textbooks, they associate them with the media. Also note that the dark lines shown in the section are artifacts due to folding that took place during tissue preparation, and they are not a distinguishing feature by any sense. Identify the type of blood vessel. Be specific, list two named vessels in the body whose wall has similar features, and what is the functional role of the wavy and coiled structures. Most of what we are seeing here is tunica media. This is the luminal surface. It has a thin, not clearly visible layer of tunica intima, and we can see that in the tunica media, that in addition to smooth muscle cells, the tunica media is seen to consist of concentric fenestrated sheets of elastin, separated by collagenous tissue and smooth muscle fibers. So again here, the predominant feature of the tunica media is the presence of elastic fibers. Part of the tunica adventitia is also shown here. You can use it to compare the rich elastic tunica media with collagenous tunica adventitia. Thus, we are looking at the wall of an elastic or conducting type of artery. These elastic arteries might be affected in aneurysm, which will affect the muscle cells in tunica media and replace them by non-contractile and non-elastic collagenous fibers, resulting in weak wall that bulges and ruptures. So again, this is an elastic artery. Returning to the second part of the question, list two named vessels in the body whose wall has similar features. In fact, elastic arteries are the largest blood vessels. Examples are the pulmonary trunk, the aorta, with its major branches such as the brachiocephalic trunk, common carotid arteries, and the subclavian arteries. the functional roles of the coiled structures, part 3 of the question, as we have just mentioned, that these wavy structures are elastic lamellae, and these are very important to maintain a continuous flow of blood in the elastic arteries. Because during systole, the wall that contains much elastine, will, like this one, will expand. And during diastole, it maintains blood pressure by means of elastic rebound of the elastine. Thus, such elastic arteries maintain a continuous flow of blood in the arterial system, as opposed to the pulsatile ejection of blood from the heart. Identify the tissue. Give two obvious reasons for your identification and identify the lines indicated by the asterisk. What is their function in relation to this tissue? These are large cylindrical cells, as you can see here, large cylindrical cells. And there is some evidence of cross striations, which is better seen in the magnified section on the left. They are thus striated muscle fibers. They have centrally located nuclei in comparison to skeletal muscle fibers, which are striated but have peripherally located nuclei. The other characteristic feature is that these cardiac muscle fibers are branching. You might see some evidence of branching here, but it is not that clear in this section. Another characteristic feature that is clearly obvious here is that these muscle fibers, cardiac muscle fibers, are joined by specialized attachment sites. This is the region of the dark intercalated discs indicated by the star. So these are features of cardiac muscle fibers, striated muscles with intercalated discs and centrally located nuclei. The intercalated discs are involved in conducting electrical impulses through the heart in order to support the synchronized contraction of cardiac tissue. In addition to anchoring junctions, the intercalated discs contain gap junctions. These are also called communicating junctions that allow the action potential to spread between cardiac muscle cells, because these gap junctions, they allow the passage of ions between cells, so producing depolarization of the heart muscle as a single functional organ or as a syncytium. In this section of the mesentery, identify vessels A, B, and C. Nuclei 1, 2, and 3 represent which type of cells. A is a venule. It's a muscular venule, to be specific, with 2 to 3 layers of smooth muscle cells. Smaller venules, which are called postcapillary venules, they don't have the smooth muscle coat. This venule, muscular, small muscular venule, has a similar structure to the nearby arteriole, B, but the lumen of the venule is larger and the wall is thinner, as you can see clearly here. In addition, this nearby arteriole B also has an internal elastic lamina, which is represented by the dark wavy line here. This is a feature present in large arterioles. It is shown here, so we are quite sure that this is an arteriole. The tunica media of the arteriole has more smooth muscle cells in its wall, 1 to 5 layers. And you can see that it is clearly thicker than that of the nearby venule. The vessel C has the thinnest wall in comparison to its lumen. It is in fact a lymphatic vessel, although not conclusive, but the absence of RBCs in the lumen of this vessel in comparison to the adjacent arteriole and venule supports the identification that it is a lymphatic vessel. Lymphatic vessels are easy to see when they are distended. Otherwise, they cannot be seen because of their thin wall. They are easily collapsed during tissue preparation. Lymphatic vessels drain excess tissue fluid and return it back to the bloodstream. For the second part of the question, cell nucleus 1 belongs to an adipocyte. These are the cells which accumulate fat, and they are commonly found in the mesentery. We are told in the question that this is a section of the mesentery. These adipocytes are separated by fine partitions of connective tissue, like here or there and here again. You can see the single large droplet, fat droplet, in the cytoplasm of the adipocyte. This pushes the remaining cytoplasm and the nucleus to one corner of the cell. During preparation of the H&E slides, the fat is dissolved and the cell appears empty with a very thin rim of cytoplasm and the nucleus is along the edge. This appearance is described as a signet ring appearance of the adipocyte or a chicken wire appearance of the adipose tissue in general. The nucleus too belongs to a fibroblast of the connective tissue partitions made of collagen fibers. This collagen is produced by the fibroblasts. Fibroblasts are spindle-shaped cells, and although the cell boundaries are not shown here, but the shape of the cell is reflected on its nucleus. Nucleus 3 belongs to a smooth muscle cell. These cells are again spindle-shaped, but larger than the fibroblasts, and the nucleus is again spindle-shaped and central. The smooth muscle cells, they form concentric layers of the tunica media of the arteriole here, and they can also be seen in the nearby venule. Identify the type of blood vessels A and B. Give two obvious reasons for your identification. Both blood vessels show the three layers of tunica intima, media, and adventitia. In blood vessel A, the vessel is less deformed because of the thick wall in comparison to vessel B. If we look closely, we will notice that the thickest layer of vessel A is the tunica media. A is thus an artery. The elastic fibers are not that prominent in this artery, so it's a muscular artery whose tunica media is mainly formed of smooth muscle fibers. The elastic fibers are condensed in an internal elastic lamina at the border with tunica intima. In larger muscular arteries, an external elastic lamina could be also seen, although it is not very clear in this vessel. Also note that in A, the cellular components of tunica intima are not clear in this magnification. Yet, we can clearly see that the tunica intima is crinkled because of the presence of the internal elastic lamina. In the vein B, you can see that it has a larger lumen and a thinner wall in comparison to the accompanying artery. Thus, it is easily deformed in tissue preparations. In addition to that, the thickest layer is the fibrous tunica externa, in contrast to the artery, whose thickest layer is the tunica media, which is made of smooth muscle fibers. Note that the intima is smooth, since there is no internal elastic lamina. So the intima is smooth and not crinkled like the intima of the artery A.